Hello everyone, in today's tutorial, I will show you how to make this disintegration effect using a material function. So this is the material function that we are going to make. So you can change the amount to see the disintegration. You can also change the color or the intensity of or the width. So if I decrease this to 0, it will be very thin. And also you can change this mask image. So if I change it to this image, then you get a disintegration like this. And if I change it to this image, then you get a disintegration like this. So you can play around with this mask image till you get a result you want. So here you can see that. So let's start. So for this, I'm just going to create a material function. So right click, materials and textures, and then material function. Then I will name this disintegrate. Then open it up. Then I will just stop this preview so we don't see the error. And I will change this to MEC. And I will duplicate this. And change this to opacity and change this sort priority to 1, so this will be below this MEC. Then I will get an input, so for that right click and type in input and function input. The name is amount, the input type is scalar, and the sort priority is 0. Now I will just duplicate this and I will change this to width. The input is also a scalar and the sort priority is 1. This is not really that important, but if I give it a value of 1, then this 1 will be the input here of the material function, this, and the sort priority of 1 will be this one, and 2 will be this, and 3 will be this, and 3 will be this, and so on. So that's what the sort priority controls. Now I'm just going to get an add node. So press and hold A and click. So we get this add node and connect this to A and connect this to B. Then we are going to create two if nodes. So press and hold I and click. So we get two if nodes. So basically an if node allows us to compare two inputs, and depending on whichever is bigger, greater or lesser, we get three outputs. So if we give a value of 1 here and 0 to B, then A is greater than B, so whatever we plug in here we get out from here, and likewise the other will work. So now I'm just going to change this value back to 0 and connect this to the B, and from here drag and connect this to A and connect this value to A greater than B, and for A equal to B and A less than B we will give a value of 0 and 0. So only when the amount changes from 0, this output will be whatever we get from this. So whenever we increase the disintegration amount, we will get this output from the add node here, otherwise the output will be 0. So connect this value to if, and for this we are going to use our mask. So for that we are going to just duplicate this. And I will name this mask So this will be a grid scale image. So the function input will be scalar because it is a grid scale input, and connect this to B. And I will name this mask, and the sort priority of this should be 2. So if A is greater than B, we will give a color here. So press and hold 3 and click. Wait, we are just going to duplicate this and change this to function input 3. So this is a color, and connect this to A greater than B. Before that, we can multiply this with a boost value, so we can increase the emissive color. So multiply this with a scalar. So duplicate this, and I will rename this to boost, and connect this to B, and the sort priority of that should be 3. So for A equal to B and A less than B, we will give it a value of 000, so it will be black, and connect this to emissive. So I will explain what is happening here. Imagine that this is an grayscale image we are giving here. So let's see. If I am using this image, then let's see a single channel of this. So the red channel. So here you can see a grayscale image. So the black portions of this image will be a value of 0, and the white portion will be a value of 1, and the grayscale value will be in between 1 and 0. So whenever we increase this amount value, it will compare with every point in this texture. So if it is here, this value might be 0.7 or something, and we will, if we are giving a value of 0.2, then it won't be higher here. So for that place, the output will be 0.0. But if you are comparing 0.2 here, and this is a black value, kind of dark value, if this value is 0.1, then we will get an output of this color. Because A is greater than B at that particular point. So that's how we are gradually disintegrating the material. So when this is 0, all values will be greater or equal to 0. So the output will be 0.0. And when the amount reaches 1, then every value will be greater than 0. So it will be completely this color that we are giving. So now we have to create the opacity, so our material will disappear. So for that, we are going to use two if nodes again, and connect this to here, and I will just create a reroute node by double clicking that, and connect this to A. Here for B, we will give this, scalar. This is a mask, so I will connect this to B. And for A greater than B and A equal to B, we will give a value of 0.0. And for A less than B, I will give a value of 1. And now connect this to A greater than B. And for B, we will give a value of 0, and for A equal to B and A less than B, we will get a value of 1 and 1. So whenever the amount is 0, there won't be any fading, and whenever this value is 1, everything will be 0. So this goes to the opacity. Now click apply and save. So that's all we need to do here. Now we will go to the probes folder of our starter content, then material, and this m underscore rock, open it up. So I already have this material function here. I'm just going to delete that. I'm just going to reset everything back. So now to add our material function, just go to the folder where we created it and drag and drop that in. And now connect this to MSC, and for opacity mask we have to go to the blend mode and change this to masked, and connect this opacity to opacity mask. And for amount we are going to create a scalar value, so press and hold S and click, so we get the scalar. Connect this to amount, and I will name this amount, and then I duplicate this, and for width I will name this width, and the default value should be 0.2, and the slider max is equal to 1, and connect this to width. Then for the mask we are going to use an image, so find an image you like. I am just using the fire image, and from the red connect this to mask. So I think we have renamed something wrong here, so let's go back to the material function, fix that. So here this is mask and this one is vector 3, this is color. Apply and save. So connect this to mask, and for the color we can press and hold V and click, so with this vector parameter, and I will name this color. And connect this to color, and for the boost I will just duplicate this and connect this to the boost, and I will name this boost, and I will give it a default value of 10 maybe. So now right click this and create a new material instance. I have already one created, so I will rename this to the new instance and open it up. Let's check if it is working or not. So you can see it is disintegrating. So let's change the color and the boost and the width. So you can change the width and the boost amount and also the color. So now let's create a the actors. So for that just go to the probes. I already have one. I'm just going to delete that and right click blueprint class actor, and I will name this rock, then open it up. Then I will create a capsule component, capsule collision. Then I will drag and drop the rock in, and for the material I will search for the new instance we created. So let's reset that also. So open that up and change the amount. So yeah, change the amount back to 0. So now I will just increase the size of the capsule to cover all of this, and I will go to event graph, then go to on component hit and drag from here and cast to first person projectile and connect this to other actor and object, and I'm just going to print this to see if it is working or not. So type in print string, then connect this here and connect this here, and let's drag and drop our actor into the world. So broke. So let's see if this is colliding. So as you can see, it is colliding. Now from here, I'm just going to delete this and drag from here and type in sequence. So we can get multiple outputs. The one of which I'm just going to use to destroy the projectile. So destroy. So now the projectile will be destroyed. Now from here I will drag and type in. Before that, drag and drop the SM rock in and drag and type in create dynamic material parameter. I mean dynamic material instance. Then connect it here. And from here drag and type in timeline. So we are going to create a timeline and open it up. Change this to 1 and add a float track and shift click here. So with this point here, change the time to 0, shift click here also and change this value to 1 and change this value to 1, then click this and this, then I'm just going to shift click here and auto, so I get this curve, and you can manipulate this to control how the disintegration happens, how fast it is. So I'm just going to keep it like this maybe. Now drag from here and type in set scalar parameter and connect this to update, and this value should be connected to the new track, and the name is amount. So let's see if this is working or not. So yeah, it's working. You can also increase the width. So let's see what this looks like. You can increase the brightness. I clamped it, I'm just going to reset that. So now you can increase the boost. So this is what it looks like. So I think that's it. You can also play with the timeline. So however you want. So you can do something like this. It is a bit weird, but you can play around with this till you get a look you want. So that's it guys, thanks for watching and subscribe for more videos like this. Thanks.